A few months ago, I was spending hours designing for my print-on-demand business. I'd scroll through templates, tweak fonts, swipe out graphics, just to make something halfway decent. And don't even get me started with the color palettes. One wrong choice, and the whole thing looked off. But then I found something that completely changed the way I design, an AI tool that does 80% of the work for me. And today I'm gonna show you exactly how it works. If you ever design for print on demand, the struggle, finding the right layout, choosing fonts that actually go together, making sure your colors don't clash, it's a process, especially when you're trying to scale your business. This process can slow you down a lot. I used to waste hours testing out different designs, second guessing myself. And honestly, that's when I discovered Kittl's AI design generator. So imagine you can describe the type of design you want and AI just creates it for you just in seconds. That's exactly what Kittl design generator does. You type in a theme, pick a style, and boom, AI generated templates that are actually good. Design generator right here, come over here, and then it'll say like logo, t-shirt, poster, sticker, social media post, advert. So for this example, we'll go ahead and do a t-shirt, and then we'll go over here and select what type you want. So right here, we look, write the subject in simple words. So a coffee shop. Let's do a little bit right here. This is why I like a little bit more of a data-driven approach to this right here. So I'm going to show you exactly what I do as far as the research process, because we're looking to create something that's going to make us money. Me personally, I do a lot of Amazon merch on demand or merch by Amazon. And if you're unaware of what that is, it's basically you upload a design to a product and the product becomes live on Amazon. The customer makes a purchase, you collect a royalty from that. So I was doing research on Amazon.com, and what you're going to do is the research process. You can use the Amazon search bar, and then you just go on and just think of different ideas, use social media, just get inspiration from there, and you can see what's selling. So I know that Axolotl, this seems to be doing really good. We're looking at the BSR here. Amazon gives us this BSR to help us understand, well, like, this gives us a sales history, right? I leverage this to see what the demand is, right? So there's two different ideas. Today, I'm a serious goose lifting weights. This was a cool one I found. This one's doing really good. And then this one right here too as well. And then remember, you're just double checking the BSR to make sure that there's a demand in this niche. So you don't want to be creating something that's not selling, right? And the main goal is to create something that is selling so you can make money. So what we're going to do is go ahead and I just typed in that gaming Axolotl t-shirt, and then this left all this blank just because, just to leave it as is. You can switch any of this if you wanted to, but just for this example, I'm going to go ahead and leave it blank. I'm going to go ahead and hit generate. And then as it hits generate, it's going to go ahead and populate some different templates, different ideas for us. All right, go ahead and hit generate again. Now, what I did was, let me go ahead and click on one of these generated ones already. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that one. The concept, get the idea. We have the idea right here. Let me go ahead and go back right here. What I just typed in is nerdy Axolotl. And then it popped up this Axolotl for us. And then the Kittl Copilot, right? Which is really cool. So we're gonna leverage this bad boy to our advantage. The text here is all more editable. The idea from this concept was a game a lotto. So we have that right there. Now we're just taking the layout. The main goal is to take the layout, the template of it that it generated for us, and then create something cool around this. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete this, delete that, and then go ahead and bring this down a bit. This right here, I like this. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna use this font right here. We're good with that one. Right, I like that too right there. And then we can go ahead and just, we're leveraging it to create the whole thing, right? The whole process and the whole idea of it. And now we can just come in here and edit the actual. So have it create the template, have it create the design, and then we can come in here and edit everything as we like. So we'll click on this. We're using Kittl Copilot to help us generate, replace the image. So we're gonna go ahead and replace this image. We're gonna do an Axolotl video game. Hit generate. All right, so it gave us a few different ideas, but there's a cute one right there. There's some good stuff here. That's cool. We're gonna use the image generator inside of Kittl. So I didn't get it. Like, it created a different one. This is a different one, right? I've never seen an Axolotl like this. That's a cool one too as well. But what we're gonna use is DALL-E 3 inside of the image generator over here. And then describe the image. So we just need so Axolotl with playing video games with a, let's see if it gets with a headset on and controller in hand. So you can, like, the different styles that you want, you can also do that too as well. So if I come in here, if I click on a style, you can see like all the different styles that it can create for me. You can even go into just line arts and stuff like that too. Mascot or cartoon. Let me do, we'll do a little cute little kawaii one. And then after that, we'll go ahead and generate image. Now, obviously, there's like, so there's a few different other ones that they're showing you back here. Oh, that's a cool one. See, as you're doing this, you're getting inspiration from other images within here. That's a cool one to look, a lizard type image. There's some really good ones in here that I like. And a turkey, this is pretty cool. So there's a lot of other inspiration in here, more styles that you can actually choose from. And you can literally just click and then it'll pop up on here. So let me go ahead and take that out. But this one right here, this one was generated with AI. So let me go ahead and expand that. We'll go ahead and hit remove background. And you see how fast and easy this is too, because we're all doing it. Look at that. It removed the background pretty good. Now with this one, if you, let's bring it over here to the side, right? Just get that, the concept and the idea of everything it created for us, right? Now we're gonna go ahead and change the text within for this one right here. All right, so what we're gonna do is, so we have everything created, then we're gonna go ahead and grab the font. You can see the font right there. Put Axolotl. One thing too, in making sure that you have the correct font size right here, you can adjust your font right here, font size right here. You can see that. So let's, let me put it up to 150. You can see that you're getting this oversized text error. So if you're getting that, just lower this until you can see right there, right? Now, everything else so on the actual artboard itself, you can center this. You have the alignment tools right here. You can just center that actual image. And boom, we got it down. And then you can actually mess with the font to how you want it. Put out an art. You can, there's a few different transformations you can do here with the actual font itself, which is really cool. So the same thing with this. You can just center that in the middle. See that? Or if you don't like it like that, say you're just not feeling that, we'll go ahead and just put it back to what you're feeling, which we can just put Axolotl right there. Let me see if you want to capitalize that and make sure that's all these are capitalized. Boom. Then we can go ahead and hit the export button with this one right here. Remove the background. You can do that. So let me go ahead. And this is ready to upload for Amazon Merch on Demand. So let me go ahead and hit the export. 300 DPI, the correct size for Amazon Merch on Demand. So let me go ahead and open it up. So it's saved to the computer to give you an idea. And there it is right there. Axolotl. All right, now this time we're going to go ahead and create the goose. So we researched it over here today. I'm a serious goose. And the same concept with that one, we did with the games. A lot of, there's a few different ways that we can do this here. Just thinking of, you can see the one that we created right there. Come over here. We created a new artboard, which is very simple, easy to do. Come over here to t-shirt. We're going to come over here to right here. We're going to just keep it a t-shirt. Write the subject in simple words. Let's go ahead and just do that. Goose working out. Leave everything else blank. Hit generate. I'm just looking for a template. I'm liking this one. I'll throw that in there right there. Generate again. I like this one too. Bring this over here. I like this one a lot. We're going to go ahead and generate an image. Let's put like a dollar. So we're going to use a goose lifting a barbell with weights on this side. See how that works out right there. We'll go over here into show the styles. Let's try the mascot one, see how that comes out. And then go ahead and generate an image. Honking. This is cool. I like the other one that we did, but I think this one's the one. I like the font here. And if you click on the font too as well, it'll tell you what type of font it is right here. Alpha slap one. Goose fit workout hunk in action. This is cool because, so if you're paying attention to this, when you're, it is giving you more in the style, these are different. Like these are, look at this rooster, the cat, the donut. Like these are all different ideas. Literally change the text out here and then you can create a completely different, like this one right here, rooster fit workout. And then maybe change like the tagline right here on the bottom, or even just erase that. This would be a good idea too as well. So this is what we're going to do. I'm just going to go ahead and remove that background. Really simple, really easy to do. Keep that image. And if you don't like that image too as well, you can literally generate another one. Again, just as simple as hit generate again, it will generate another one for you. And because it's simple and just put this together, making sure we got it lined up correctly. And boom, right there. You can see that. It's literally that simple. Now, it's like you can get the concept from here, but today I'm a serious goose. But this one's not Goose Fit Workout Honk in Action. This is not bad at all. I think this is a really cool design. It's good. I like it a lot right here. And then the same thing with this one. You can go ahead and hit export, right? Export, and it's ready to, and we can remove the background. Boom. And it's just saved to your computer. Go over there and click. Boom. There it is with the remove background and everything. Goose Fit Workout Honk in Action. One more thing to point out too, if you feel like this looks more like a duck compared to a goose or geese, you can come in here and just literally put that to the side, generate again, or you can just grab something over here and then boom, this works pretty good too, huh? This one's pretty good. This works pretty good. You can make it just a tiny bit bigger if you want, center it, and the same thing too as well over here. Bam, that looks clean too. Now, me personally, I like to mix in research from Amazon.com. This idea, this niche right here, today I'm a serious goose. This concept, this idea is doing really good on Amazon. You're going to see basically just a goose lifting up some weights, right? And the research that I personally done was just going through Amazon, doing some searching and coming up with different ideas. I create a lot of that on this channel. So if you haven't checked that out and you want to see how I do research personally, check out my other videos on this channel. I dive in really deep with research because that's a whole nother video. But the idea that I look for here is you're seeing the BSRs, right? That means that there's a demand. We're looking for demands on Amazon.com because most likely if it's selling on Amazon, it's going to be selling on Etsy. It's going to be selling on Redbubble, TeePublic, all the other print-on-demand platforms. And this is the number one online shopping platform. So why wouldn't you want to do research over here? And then if you take a look over here, so GooseFit Workout Hunk in Action, you can also keep in mind all the text, you can edit all the text too as well. So from like the sizing of the font, the spacing and the lettering, the different font styles, there's a ton of different font styles back here that you can choose from, which is really amazing. But what we did, we leveraged AI to help us do pretty much do all the heavy lifting back here in Kittl, which is amazing because you can see how just a few clicks of a button and then it just pretty much does the heavy lifting, 80% of it. And then we come up with our own cool, unique design that's different. Now, we're taking the inspiration from here, getting the concept, getting the idea, just a goose working out. So took that concept and we came over here and we created our own unique idea, which is pretty cool. So what do you think? Would you let AI help you with your designs? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you found this helpful, make sure you subscribe to my channel because I have more game-changing tools coming your way. And I'm going to have a link down below in the description for Kittl AI.